Bacteria may be among the simplest living beings in the world, yet they still hide lots of secrets. For example, how they swim. Bacteria use very different swimming mechanisms, but they all come down to one thing: displacing fluid around them, generating flows. In fact, guess what? You don't need to be alive in order to swim. Scientists have invented Janus particles, tiny metal beads with two different faces that generate the same flows, meaning they can swim pretty much the same way as bacteria do. All these folks swim differently depending on the obstacle's shape. Let's keep things nice and consider a spherical obstacle. What happens when a swimmer meets such an obstacle? Well, scientists have built equations telling that those swimmers could go on an orbital motion. For all kinds of spheres? Well, that depends on the model. But there is one big condition. Scientists calculated that the obstacle should be at least 10 times bigger than the swimmer for an orbital motion to occur. And, well, bacteria seem to behave just as they predicted. Yay! But then, people tried with Janus particles. And wait a minute. Yes, there are orbits, but too many. For literally any obstacle sizes from 1.5 to 20 times larger than the swimmers. This contradicts the aforementioned models, and as usual, asks even more questions. For example, where do the models go wrong? Are Janus particles so identical to bacteria? Could their differences in shape explain these diverging behaviors? After all existing models have to approximate the swimmer shape, and sometimes even neglect it. This leaves us with tons of possible ways to improve our models. In the future, this could be helpful to do bacteria guiding or understanding bacteria behaviors around cells, since cells are also big spherical obstacles.